Kick up the ute. Man, know that I kick up the ute. Them boy there try to suck the truth. How dare you to suck the truth? Look, you're getting way too big for your boots. You're never too big for the boot. I got the big size toes on my feet. Your face ain't big for my boots. Kick up the ute. Man, know that I kick up the ute. Them boy there try to suck the truth. How dare you to suck the truth?
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. What a bitter game this promises to be. These division matchups always call for some extra explosiveness in the passing game, and this is the man they'll be looking to deliver it. It's the Patriots going up against the Bats.
Thank you very much. It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the New England Patriots and our home team. Hi again, everyone. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we look at this Brooklyn ball club. They come in on a pretty good roll here, winners of three straight.
And the offense last week, they had things humming. If you're a defensive player, you may get overshadowed a little bit, but you're really buoyed by what your offense is doing.
On the other side of the field for the visiting Patriots, it's been all systems go in this first month. They're off to a 4-0 start.
And as scout folks believe that this is a team that's built to go all the way. You can't win the Super Bowl in September, but they're telling everyone that they're going to be there in the end.
So out comes this offense to take over for the first time. And they will be led out by their 6'4 quarterback. This up only to about the 33. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line, hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you got to feed them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play well, the quarterback can't wait to feed them afterwards.
Let's see what the offense comes with here. Second and 8. They'll set up to throw. And he's got his man on the out route. They give him 13 yards there on the play and a fresh set of downs. He's a reigning AFC Offensive Player of the Week, and defensively, they have to find an answer for him.
And that's what you would do if you were calling plays, right?
Yeah,
you'd make sure that he gets targeted. But the thing about it is the route running. That's what makes him so dangerous, is because no matter what is presented defensively, he runs his route with such skill that he's able to go up and get the football first in each and every situation.
Here we go now. 319.
And a give this time to the tailback. He had a great strong move, but he'll still be stopped shy of midfield. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8. A quick look here at the Patriot defense.
Dante Hightower is a prototypical run-stuffing inside linebacker who has the ability to go to the edge and rush the passer, and there's no better example than when he had the strip sack against Matt Ryan in Super Bowl 51.
And they still need 8 yards for the first here on second down. He'll look to throw. Going down the middle, and it's complete. They got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. And he's already got 2 catches on the opening drive. They know he's going to be a handful.
And sometimes you game plan for that offensively. You want to make sure that guy touches the ball, and sometimes it just has your game plan. When he has the hot hand, you keep going. To him because he's running routes with confidence as the game goes on.
Here we go now. Green 39.
And he'll give it here to his running back. Down to the 30 after a gain of 3. Pretty much unreal, not just in terms of yardage, Charles, but also throwing the 3 touchdowns as well.
When you put the whole package together, I can make you a pretty good guarantee right now. He's going to see that? A few more people in the box every time he lines up.
Yeah, I don't think that the defense has any choice. They've got to stop him. Can't let a repeat performance like that.
Agreed. But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Into the red zone now, and Charles, they told us offense in the red zone was a focus this week in practice.
A huge priority, and the key was to get points, so you know that all the time during the week they talked about executing, taking care of the football.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. A great play there. His 4th touchdown on the year. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. Well, these guys have won 3 straight ball games, and another good start to this one out to the 6-0 lead.
And I've talked with so many different coaches, as have you along the way, and they always talk about winning streaks and the mood of a team and how much easier it is to actually prepare during that time. Guys are sharp, guys are focused, everyone's feeling good, and we're seeing it early in this one.
It's the Colts in that one that have grabbed the early lead. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. And they'll be set up pretty nicely here as they have it up to the 35-yard line. Getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again. Last week, over 100 yards, 3 touchdowns. We were talking with him on the field before the game. He said simply, "I was in a groove." He obviously was.
And I think he's been a little modest about that, being in a groove. That's a big-time game right there. And I think he feels like his entire team is coming along with him because they're creating spaces and holes for him to run through. He's making people miss, running through tackles. They are locked in a big way and confident about this game as well.
And hard running's going to get him over the 40 to the 42. Offense staying ahead of the chains here, 2nd and 3. Now a handoff here to his running back. And very little daylight there. He'll get a couple up to the 44.
If they're going to get a first down out of this, they're going to have to earn it because there's been tough going in the interior there. And here we are on 3rd and 1. Be prepared. Brace yourself. There'll be some contact going on.
Hurry up. Here we go. Green 39. Green 39.
They'll look to throw for it on 3rd and 1. Throws a quick hitter on the slant. That's complete. He gets 7 out of it, and he also gets a first.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
And the offense lining up 1st and 10.
Blue 90. Blue 90.
And they give this time to the tailback. And that play will go nowhere, losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It'll be a loss of a yard, and it'll be second and 11.
Okay, let's just make this one simple. We know that the running game is not their thing, but they can't just throw it on every single down without expecting some real heat from the pass rush.
Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. Wide open receiver complete. 15 yards through the air and a first down. How about the first quarter he's putting together out wide? Pretty impressive.
I think that he likes the fact that we're playing this as a day game. You know, some guys, they respond better in the evenings. For some reason, it builds up. For this guy, day game, and he is off and running. You're exactly right. 100 might be conservative with the start that he's had here in the first quarter.
Yeah, by the numbers, he's on pace for 200-plus right now. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10. He'll drop to throw. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And a nice gain of 21 yards. This drive, it's been a good mix. Three passing plays, three runs, hitting on all three of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9.
Sometimes play calls boil down to philosophy. You know you're facing one of the top 10 units against the run in the NFL. So do you decide to keep smashing against them, or do you decide to throw the ball here?
Let's go! Boo, Lanny! Boo, Lanny!
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. And he will take it in for the touchdown. And correct me if I'm wrong, that was just a simple fly route, wasn't it?
No, there's nothing to correct at all. You got it down pat. And I just remember as a player, I'd be in practice sessions, and I'd hear 9 from the receivers. That meant fly route, go. Uh-oh, look out.
Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This will be taken about the 12. Spins away, and he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Running back, and not much, maybe a yard up to the 29.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again, go play action, hit them over the top.
The NFL on EA Sports is fueled by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Brooklyn football as we get going in quarter number 2. They've got a 2nd and 9 to start things out. 9 yards still remaining here to pick up the first on 2nd down. They'll run it now out of the gun. Fighting through, and he's going to be out of bounds right at the 40. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
And a give this time to the tailback. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this into enemy territory across the 40. Chewing up big yardage. Another nice gain there. This one goes for 20.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack. And guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
And he'll give it here to his running back. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here, because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last 4 plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, 4 plays in this drive, all 4 on the ground. Shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. It's a pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains. Fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And when you get good yardage like that on first down, it really does a whole lot of good for your entire offense. But I love the way he's finishing those runs. At the end of things, he's making sure he gets just a little bit extra.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll fight forward maybe to the line of scrimmage, but that's all. Now whistles here, and we've got a man down. Man down on the field. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. Here's the 7th play of this drive. This is 3rd and 4.
All right, here we go. Green, 39. Green, 39.
Looking to throw. Able to shake him off. That's incomplete, but there is a flag down. So hang on. A big call coming on 3rd down.
Holding offense.
And they will elect to decline the penalty.
Everything turned out the way they wanted it to.
Here we go now. Blue 90. Blue 90.
And they give this time to the tailback. And they get to him quickly here as he stopped right around the 13. Give him a couple on the carry there, 2nd and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8, now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
They'll look to throw. And it's caught. Touchdown. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
And it's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, 2 touchdowns already here through the 2nd quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
Buffalo. The Bills have taken an early lead against the Dolphins. That one tight to this point, and you'd have to imagine it'll stay tight throughout. Yeah, some might have returned that one. He won't. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start the drive from the 25. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Set! 319! 319!
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll wind up with about six, up past the 30 to the 31.
Let's talk a little football 101 here, because one of the keys to advancing the ball downfield, success on first down. Huge difference, as we know, between second and four and second and eight and nine.
Shotgun. He'll look to throw. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. He's lucky to be getting that one back.
After what they've done with him all day long, with all the targets trying to go after him, he's obviously gotten smart, and his pride has kicked in. Made a terrific play.
So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. They'll set up a throw. Going down the middle. It's complete. The 21 yards here as they convert on third. Well, there's your leading receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage, putting on another clinic well over 100 yards.
Are we taking notes? We should be, right? Because I'm going to go back and watch this tape and really enjoy what I'm seeing. The route running, competing for the football, just breaking down a defense.
Running back, and he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
This time to the tailback, and just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. Just a 1 yard pickup on the play, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
Gun now on third down. Oh, a battle for it here, and this will be caught. 15 yards through the air and a first down. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
Give it here to his running back, and he'll get about four as he's brought down at the 24. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Hurry up, here we go. Boom,
3 as he's taken down at the 14-yard line. Under 4 to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down. Now back to throw. And here he'll get it down to the 7. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down. The offense on third down, they've been good. 3 for 4 thus far. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. They're going to look to throw. This will be caught at about the 6. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the 3. Give him a gain of 4, able to convert, and that sets up 1st-and-goal now.
Sometimes they get lost in the traffic, but usually what it means is that rather than just winning with height or even speed, they use their quickness to find a way to get open.
It's the Colts in that one that have grabbed the early lead. I have a feeling that one's going to stay tight throughout. We'll continue to monitor. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Now this offense ready to head back out there. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
It was tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there. That can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
They go play action here on 1st down. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off around the 41, and the return will be stopped at the 34-yard line. And he may want to track down that football because that's interception number 1 on his career.
You're saying that's going into the trophy case?
I'd put it there.
Yeah, no doubt about it. That's when you ask the equipment guys to make sure they hold it for you after the game. But if you play in the back 7 on defense, that's part of your job, finding ways to take the ball away from the other team.
There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the 2nd quarter. What might they change offensively? The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Now a handoff here to his running back. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. So we come upon halftime with 9 points separating these 2 teams. as we'll send you down the coast to Orlando, where we check in with our friend Larry Ridley and the EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry?
All right, Brandon, we'll see if I can get through this without being skipped as we welcome you to our EA Sports Halftime Report. The Bats are up right now and are looking to keep up the pressure moving forward. The Patriots just want to come out after the half and claw their way back into the game. All right, let's do it. Here's a look at the first half highlights. Now first and 10, they'll go to the ground and pound here, and he capped off the seven-play drive with a score. We're tied back up at 7. Bats now late in the first quarter. The pass will be completed into coverage, and he capped off the long drive with the TD. The lead grows to 4. Now second and 8, pass coverage will break down here, and he capped off the 9-play drive with the TD. The lead now at 8. Now to late in the second. Pinkston's the target here, and he capped off the long drive with a touchdown. That takes the lead up to 12. So that'll do it from our studios.
Second half is underway up in Orchard Park, and it's the Bills that have added to their lead. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. They'll score that a 36-yard punt, and the offense will come back out deep in their own territory. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Now how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. And not much there at all as he'll get this only up to about the 11. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a 2nd and 9.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
They'll run it now out of the gun, and he'll get this one up to about his 14. Only a gain of a couple there. That leaves him needing about 7 here on third down.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just going to ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's so good at that, isn't he?
I think he knew right away that he wasn't going to get to his primary guy. I think he read that as soon as he got to the line of scrimmage, knew where the pressure was going to come from, and said, I know how to beat that, and that's what he did.
Only a couple there as he'll be brought down about the 28.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple of yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage look defensively.
Here we go now. 319. 319.
He'll look to throw. Quick throw that's complete on the inside slant. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. They'll drop to throw. And he's got his favorite target yet again. It's complete. And he takes this one down all the way near the 30. A really nice gain of 25 yards. Now, he's certainly been a huge factor in this one. He's got the two touchdowns to his credit. Now they look to him again. He picks up the first.
Yeah, I can hear everyone saying, well, why don't you cover him? Double him, triple him, do what you have to do. But sometimes they get locked into such a groove and such a connection, it doesn't matter how many guys are in his area.
He certainly looks to be in that groove right now. So the offense has it first and 10. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. 11 more on that one and another first down.
Looks to me like maybe there's a little attrition setting in with this drive. Because when you see that type of a run, I get the feeling the defense getting a little bit tired.
And that's the last thing they need, especially when they look up at the scoreboard. So the run moves the chains, and here we go on first down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And not much to speak of there. Maybe a yard down to the 20.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there. And it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. And the eighth play on this drive coming up. They'll look to throw here. His throw caught right around the 6. That one goes for 16 yards. It sets him up first and goal. And a good quarterback facing zone coverage, if he has just a little bit of time to survey the scene, that's what's going to happen.
No doubt about it. If there's no pressure, he's going to continue to pick them apart because he'll have all that time to find someone open downfield. He can only cover for so long. So maybe they want to go to a zone blitz scheme, get a little bit more pressure. Remember when Carolina did that against Denver? They lost the game ultimately. They dropped the defensive end out, and he ended up with an interception in that game in Super Bowl 50. Maybe some sort of scheme like that to try and get more pressure at the passer.
And it's caught. Touchdown.
You have fun with this one, partner?
I am. I mean, he's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right, when we see people get into the zone. This guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving him up.
Four touchdown passes, carving him up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. And they'll get set here looking for the two-point conversion. They'll look to throw. And this is going to be caught. It's good. And that extends their lead by two more. And around the goal line, especially on two-point tries, sometimes the QB's best friend is that big target, the tight end.
I love how you described it because you know he's going to have some length and some kick.
Here's Ryan Quigley now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. This is taken at the 15. It's a return of 4 following a 42-yard punt. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. There he is, the man taking the snaps under center, heading out for the next possession. Really solid effort for him right now. Third quarter, already 4 touchdown passes. How many can he get here?
That remains to be seen, but I know one thing. You and I will be here to watch, and I'm not going
going anywhere with what he's doing in this contest. I'm not missing a minute of it. This guy's been spectacular.
Yeah, I mean, it's a team game, but sometimes these individual performances are fun to watch.
Yeah, sometimes they just kind of come to the front, despite the fact, as you said, we know it's all about the team, but the way he's playing, he's trying to make his team win on his back.
Yeah, it's been exciting. Seven yards to go on second down. For 18 there as the drive will continue. His big game continues. Already has the 3 touchdown grabs, tacking on some more yardage and a first down.
And how precise has his route running been in this game? We just saw him get open yet again. And he's also made adjustments as the defense has tried to really stop him.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. Here to his running back. He'll get about 3 as he's brought down right around the 42.
In my book, that's running the ball well, but with intelligence. How about him keeping the clock moving, staying in bounds?
Yeah, even though it's the third quarter, you're thinking ahead, aren't you? This is where your running game can really help you with a lead in the second half.
I agree totally. It's not just end of the half situations that you worry about the clock. It's throughout the game, and with a lead, stay in bounds. Make them fight harder to try and catch you.
He will find his man on the outside, and he'll get it out to midfield. Let's say, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Back now just east of Manhattan in Brooklyn, as it looks like we are just about set and ready to begin with the fourth. Give this time to the tailback, and he'll get this into enemy territory, but not by much, as he's down to the 48. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with 3rd and 5.
They're in a pretty good spot right now with a convincing lead. I think this is where they put on the boxing gloves, start to try and pound them into submission.
And the offensive line, they've controlled this game. I don't see why that trend would change now. Guy, they needed a big play there on 3rd down, went his way, it worked out.
Doesn't matter whether they scouted it or that they think he's going to get the ball. He has a knack for finding his way open and completing the connection.
So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. Down to the 10-yard line. 10 more there and another first down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
And he'll give it here to his running back. A nice display of power, but it only takes him to the seven. He's dropped there. It'll be a 3-yard pickup, and it brings up second and goal. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
Second and goal to go now. And it's caught. Touchdown. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
Here to his running back, and he'll take this one up close to about the 45. They are in the fourth in Buffalo. And you saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Cam Newton, 2 touchdown passes thus far. So the offense looking at a 2nd and 8. Going to give this time to the tailback, and he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about 5.
Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
This offense so far on third down, they've been excellent, 6 for 7. This time it's 3rd and 3. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And he's got it. Got his man on the end route. Complete. 15 yards through the air and a first down. He's played a great game. It continues right there, even with this lead. Confident to throw the pass and have the reception made.
There's no doubt who the leader of their team is there? There's no doubt who they want to ride all the way to the finish. Because strategy would tell you, run the football, run the clock down. Instead, they're letting him throw it because they feel that confident in what he's getting done.
So here we go, 1st and 10 now. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. It's a pickup of 4, and it'll bring up 2nd down.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. Now a handoff here to his running back. He winds up getting only a couple there, down to the 29. And defensively going with a dime set, 6 DBs on 3rd and 4.
Green 39!
takes it down to the 13 and picks up the first. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. Now defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
Time to the tailback, and he'll be taken down here at about the 11. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. Looks like the defense in press coverage here.
She's doing more than humming. She's belting it out right now.
She's going. She's full bore.
Yeah, this thing is flat out finished.
As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. And he uncorks a beauty, best of the day. And problems spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. Out comes this offensive unit as they get set to take over here. And Charles, in a very one-sided affair, I think we've reached the point in the broadcast where you and I, we may have some filling to do, right?
Yeah, I think you're right about that, because we got to try to keep people around. We don't want them to change the channel. Stay with us in this game. Is that Ben Ramsey? Are you hearing from Ben on the headset here? Tell us.
Stretch
this thing out a little bit.
Get some talking points. Dig them all out.
That's what you get. A big-time producer. Keep them here.
Credited with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Brandon, is all about pace and tempo now for them. They've got the advantage, so I'm going to put musical terms for you. You don't want to go prestissimo. That's too quick, too lively, right? But you also don't want to slow it down too much. You don't want to go lento. What you really want to be is moderato. Nice and even, nice and steady, get those gains, and close out the game.
I think that chicken parm from last night's gone to your head. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead them to third down. This offense on third down today, they've been flat getting it done, 8 for 9 to this point. This is third and 8.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19.
They'll run it now, out of the gun. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll get this up only to about the 33. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
In order to play really good run defense when you're playing a 3-4, those three guys up front, the nose tackle and the guys they call the defensive ends, they're usually big, big people, because they're going to have to eat up a lot of blockers, because it's usually 5-on-3. And when they do their job well, guys who play on the inside, those inside linebackers, they will just roam and hit.
Now a handoff here to his running back, and he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a
the middle calls, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense? What's that, five straight runs?
Yeah, five straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. And this defense looks for one more stop here on third after the run. To the sideline. Wow, what a catch. Doesn't get a lot out of it, but he is able to keep the feet in bounds. They get only four that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
I know where we're headed on this. Terrific catch. Gets his feet down. Sets up a fourth down in short situation. But I bet we're wondering, why didn't he get to the first down marker running his route? Am I correct?
You got to know where the marker is, right? And emerging victorious, the Colts. A win, if they can get it, would be their first on the year. And they give this time to the tailback. And he'll get this one down to about the 27.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. But Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
And as an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the home team here, they boost their record up to a strong 4-1. And they'll be able to enjoy this one through the bye week before they get back at it again. Meanwhile, for the Patriots, it was a good first month, but they'll fall to 4-1 as they suffer their first loss. And they'll look to regroup next week as they head down to Miami to take on the Dolphins. So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaughan. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say so long, everybody.